Welcome back to the channel. This is part three of the 2024 TransAlp mods videos. So I finally got the Bark Buster handguards. They were on back order for quite a while, so they finally came in. I'm just doing the installation right now. So I've already got started. I forgot to film the first little bit, but there's not really much to it. I'm going to take off the original bar ends, which I've got over here. So those were the original bar ends that were in. They're in really tight, a lot of torque in them. So those are the originals. The Bark Busters come with new ones and spacers that go in there. And then you have to move. So I moved this over just a little bit, as they called for, but I don't think I needed to. And then you just assemble this bracket, and everything's just loose here now, and I'm just going to get ready to do the other side. So this side is pretty much the same. The spacer that goes in here is a little bit bigger. I think it's 2 millimeters bigger, and there's a small washer that also goes in on this side. I think that's to let the throttle run a little smoother. They say to move this over a little bit. I did loosen it up, but I'm going to leave it right in place just to see where things line up. So I'm going to put the bracket that runs from here to the back of here. I just want to see where it lines up first, and then I'll move this if I need to. So you do have to loosen this up quite a bit to get this to fit down in there. It's quite a tight fit, if you can see down in there, but that does have to get loosened up quite a bit, but there is some room once it's in there. So then you just tighten this back up. So I've got these installed. I don't have the guards on yet, but all I have is throttle sticks. So I looked online and apparently there's a possibility with OEM heated grips, you have to add extra washers in here. So I've got to dig up some extra washers that are going to fit, and try to get some extra washers in here and see if that will remedy the problem. So I added just one little washer and perfect. Smooth. No problem at all. So just I left the washer that came with it and just added one washer. I added two, and the gap was too much. So I just left one in there and it's fine now. So I'm gonna tighten everything up. I'm gonna try to level everything up here, and then start tightening things up and then put the storm shields on. Okay, there they are. Installation's complete. Wasn't too bad, went really well. The only problem I really had is, like I said, I had to add an extra washer on the throttle side. Oh, actually, that's sticking again now that I've got everything tightened up. Maybe I will have to add another washer in there. Gotta loosen that up just a hair, it may. Funny that started to stick again. Well, I'll have to play with that some more. The installation really isn't too bad. Like I say, that's kind of the only issue I've had. I just got the black storm guards. They don't look too bad. I mean, the whole bike is black, so I just kind of went with it. I bought these little side wind deflectors. I haven't had the bike out to try them yet. I suspect I'm going to put a taller windscreen on as well, for when I'm touring. And I'm not sure what else I've done to the bike in the last little while. Just put this little tail bag on. I had a great big top box, but I sent it back. I wasn't really happy with it. It's just too big, and there's a little scratch in it when I ordered it as well, so I sent it back. Got this little tail bag for now. So that's everything that I've got done right now. I do have a center stand on order. So I've got to do a cut a piece off my skid plate. I've got to cut about 3.5 inches back on my skid plate for the Outback Motor Tech center stand to fit. So once that arrives, I'll take that skid plate off and get that center stand installed. And other than that, I'm in pretty good shape. By then, the weather should be good, and get some good riding going. So it turns out, the tighter I have this, if I have this really, really tight, it affects the throttle. Not exactly sure how, but I loosen that up just a little bit. It's still plenty tight. It's not going anywhere. And the throttle's fine now. That's the bar end weights and everything are really tight. Just loosen that up a little bit. It's fine. So that job's done. We're just gonna wait for the center stand now, and we'll continue on with that when it arrives. So I didn't get a lot of filming done for the Outback Motor Tech center stand for the TransAlp, but I did have some problems. The install is pretty easy. It goes fairly quickly. It just kind of slides right in there. There's one bolt just up in there that holds it in place. And then there's this double spring. There's a small one that goes inside a large one. It's a bit of a job to stretch it down and to hook over this lip right here. That's a bit of a job. When I originally installed it, I put the bike up on the center stand, took it down once. When I put it back up, that inside small spring broke. So I'm not sure why it broke. But it did. Like I said, it was only the second time that I put the bike up on the stand, just here in the garage. So I contacted the company that I bought it from. They sent me a new spring and I reinstalled it. And that's what I just did right now, just installed it. And so hopefully this one will work. I'd asked them if they had issues with the springs. They said they didn't. This is the same size springs that are on the Africa Twin. So they've sold quite a few of them. They said that it's not an issue. So hopefully it won't. But the bike goes up on the stand quite easily, actually. A lot easier than I thought it would. So that's good. So it's nice to, it's going to be nice to have a center stand. So anyway, that install's done. So that's about all that I have done for mods right now. And the weather's getting better, so I'm looking forward to get out and do some riding. Can't remember if I had said previously, I did cut back the skid plate. The skid plate originally came back to about here. I think I cut about 4 inches off. So it did come back here, but in order to have the center stand, you have to cut, I think it was almost 4 inches. So I'm almost back to the bracket that the skid plate screws up into or bolts up into. So it's just about pretty much 4 inches that they took off the back. And it all fits pretty good here now. So that's about it for this video.